rather fitting in a way, perhaps, that on a night of such theatre here in Newcastle, we do have the opportunity to remind us that it's men like those two who provide the hotbed of boxing. Those are the sort of young men who put their bodies on the line week in, week out to make this the great sport that it is. A great spectacle at the top level, and showmen like Hamed, fill arenas like this. But even for the Prince Naseem Hameds at the top of world boxing, there's a community spirit feel to their preparations. And Adam Smith witnessed an extraordinary day out for Hamed and the rest of the Brendan Eagle camp in the build-up to this big fight tonight.
Lindholm, South Yorkshire. 670 inmates. No way out. These faces are preparing the ultimate ring challenge behind bars. Naseem Hamed will lead his Sheffield fighters into unknown territory. The prisoners wait with open arms.
Naz, I'm going to give you these. I'm going to knock you out 100%. You're all mine. The number two round, you're going down. See you later.
Meanwhile, Sheffield's ringmaster, Brendan Ingle, is rousing his troops, for their careers are on the line. At the appointed hour, the prince moved in.
You namche!
But being featherweight king carries little weight inside. To the guards, he's just another visitor to search. To the inmates, he's an equal. Naz needed to outsight them to gain any respect.
You can't put these muscles on your chin.
I know that.
So if you get banged on this chin, you know what's going to end up happening, don't you?
Remember.
The prisoners gathered for a final team talk. Rules: inmates can hit boxers, but boxers can't hit back. Naz had his troops buzzing, and he wasn't conforming to any laws.
There's no rules. There's no rules and no regulations. You've just got to get out there and fight for your right. At the end of the day, we're in prison. But at this moment in time, I can honestly say I'm in prison. But I'm not here for doing anything. I'm here just basically doing a boxing exhibition.
500 packed into the arena. Public on one side, prisoners segregated on the other. They knew Naz wouldn't fight with a crucial defence 8 days away, but you can't stop him entertaining. His gym members followed suit, and so did the inmates. The action got underway, the prisoner wading forward for the knockout, the boxer Johnny Nelson using skill and speed. This is very much Naseem's style, natural balance and movement demonstrated to perfection by young middleweight Ryan Rhodes. Heavyweight Pelle Reed went for raw power. And Herbie Hyde scored the first knockdown in his comeback. The only risk Naz was taking was to mix with the crowd. While back in the ring, the boxers began to suffer. John Thaxton caught. Paul Griffin roughed up. And Kevin Adamson in so much trouble, Naz threw in the towel. The final embarrassment was left to Clifton Mitchell. His fight on June the 8th almost bit the dust. Naz wanted to restore the pride and was dying to join in. Fortunately, Brendan called a halt to proceedings. Respect had grown between boxer and prisoner. The evening had been a tremendous success and £1,000 raised for local charities. Naz had taken time out for the fun, but now it's business and this vital world title fight.
I'm feeling victorious as I've always felt again, and I just can't wait for the fight because somebody's going to get knocked out and it ain't going to be me.
The prince emerged relatively unscathed from his time inside, but as he makes a transition back into the outside world, he might find real danger in unbeaten Daniel Alicea.
Superb to see the spirit of boxing carried right across the breadth of the community there. Jim, he doesn't do very much that's orthodox in his preparations, Naseem Hamed. What do you make of the way he gets ready?
I don't think there's anything orthodox, whether it's his lifestyle, his preparation, or the way he actually boxes. That's what makes it so difficult for other fighters to prepare for him. But you couldn't possibly change Naz and ask him to do the things in the normal manner. He would lose everything he has. But for other fighters like Johnny Nelson and Errol Bomber Graham, who were equally difficult to hit, but it's Naz's power that shocks and surprises me. Tremendous power. Doesn't have to assert himself to deliver that power. Tremendous power for a featherweight.
Barry, will he surprise Daniel Alicea with that tonight?
I think he will surprise him. Looking at Alicea in the dressing room, it would appear that Alicea doesn't really realise what he's getting himself in for. He's 15 fights with 15 wins and plenty of stoppages along the way there. But quite honestly, he's only a baby and he has not had a chance to develop. We see him here against Marcus McRae and in one of his earlier fights. Good work coming forward, non-stop aggression, stays on top of you, keeps pressurising you, punches from all different angles. Again, we see him here against Luis Spada, working the body, using the jab, getting up close, and you know, there's no doubt about it, he's a good, thorough professional, but still too early in his career to have developed into the complete package. You know, that's what my doubts are. But there's no doubt, finishing ability, what's the way he finishes? When he has you in trouble here, great left hook, finished Spada there, just a little short left hook, done the trick.
Potentially, do you feel he's got the punch power to do what so many of you professionals have said, that Naseem Hamed has not actually been really hit in on the chin yet?
Well, no, I don't think this guy has the sort of concussive punching power to take Naz out with one shot anyway. But he certainly has enough power to hurt him. What I'd like to see is, I'd like to see Naz get into a situation where he has to dig deep and he has to fight in the trenches. That really will answer the questions that we would all like to see. And if he has got those qualities, he would be one hard act to follow, one difficult opponent to beat.
Only one place to find out, and it's live on Sky Sports. Big Time Boxing. Naseem Hamed has astonished us through his appearances on our programmes in the last year or so. Can he rack it up another notch tonight with the United States market watching for the first time live coast to coast with us? We shall see after this break. Prince Naseem Hamed has swept all before him on this side of the Atlantic as he makes his second defence of the WBO World Featherweight title tonight against Daniel Alicea from Puerto Rico. He's not only being watched live on Sky Sports throughout Britain, but live on American television as well. So Hamed hopes to launch himself onto the world stage tonight in every sense. He's got to do it in the ring. It's the only place in boxing where the arguments get truly sorted out. And tonight we'll see if he can take another step towards his avowed intention of becoming one of the all-time greats. So far, so good. Our commentary team tonight, once more Glenn McCrory and Ian Dark. And we're just hearing that Daniel Alicea is getting his gloves taped up. And in just a moment or two, he will be on the way in front of this heaving arena here at the Newcastle Arena. It's a superb indoor stadium, and for the second time already this year they have come close to a sellout here for a major boxing event. Laden Races being sung in the background, the anthem of the Northeast. Football's a huge passion, and so too is boxing down the years, and this crowd certainly makes you believe that boxing has a big future in this part of the country. Hamed fighting in front of a Newcastle audience for the first time. Alicea, no stranger to these shores. This will be the fourth time in the past 12 months that he's fought in Britain. Will it be his biggest performance so far? Let's hear from Jimmy Lennon Jr.
As they make their way to the ring, first we introduce to you tonight's challenger and number one contender, introducing Daniel Alicea.
Puerto Rico's Daniel Alicea entering to a chorus of boos. Probably we could do without that kind of reception. He's the first young, unbeaten, ambitious fighter that Prince Naseem Hamed has fought. He may well be dangerous. On the other hand, with Hamed's power, he could be blown away quickly like the rest of them. Good amateur pedigree, world junior champion, unbeaten in 15 as a professional, 13 of those inside the distance. No telling really how good he just might be, but tonight it must be said he's moving from the paddling pool into the ocean. Alicea has been making the obligatory noises about knocking Hamed out. But does he have the answers to Hamed's speed, elusiveness and punch power? That's the question, Glenn.
It certainly is. He looks focused, he looks up at the fight, but he's shouting at the camera. And you can't criticise his credentials. As an amateur, very good, world champion as a junior, undefeated as a professional. He's young and he looks hungry.
Good young fighter. Another question is, has this chance come just a wee bit too early for him? Daniel Alicea, Puerto Rico. Doesn't look like a fighter who's about to freeze on the big occasion, does he? Young, brash, unbeaten so far, full of self-belief. Bit like the Brits, really.
Yes, very much. That's what makes this such a great match. Both undefeated, both young, both hungry for success.
Not everybody's giving him a great chance. In fact, the American bookmakers, one of them anyway, has Prince Naseem Hamed as a 20-1 favourite to retain his title tonight. Alicea will have other ideas.
And now, making his way
ring entrance has he cooked up for us tonight, I wonder. Whatever it is, he's taking his time doing it, Glenn.
He certainly is. Plenty small.
Well, it looks like he's starting to believe that he's a real prince.
I think so.
Just as long as they don't carry him out of the ring as well.
Well, I'm sure he'll have other ideas about that, but he certainly found a different entrance. Well, the crowd, they don't see many things like this in Newcastle.
They don't see many things like this in Las Vegas.
The prince is walking from here. Let's do it.
Well, not even Muhammad Ali or Sugar Ray Leonard ever tried anything quite like this. Not to everybody's taste in professional boxing, it must be said. But this man is all about showmanship and theatre. And he is a ticket seller and he has caught the public's imagination. And woe betide any fighter who tries to make this kind of ring entrance who can't fight. This fellow can.
That's right. Well, one man just looking who is enjoying this entrance very much is Alicea. He's dancing in the corner, lots of big smiles. So I think he's enjoying the whole atmosphere here.
Newcastle's Naseem Hamed makes Chris Eubank look like an introvert. Let's check the tail of the tape for this fight. Alicea, the older man by a year, though he's less experienced, much taller too, look, 5'7" against 5'3", same weight, just inside the 9-stone limit. Alicea only 15 fights, Hamed's only had 21 though, and he's knocked out 19 of those opponents. Both of them used to very short fights, an average of 3.5 rounds per fight each.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, before we continue with our action, at this time we ask you to please be upstanding for the playing of the national anthem.
Las olas a sus pies cuando a sus playas llegó Colón, exclamó lleno de admiración. Oh, esta es la linda tierra.
Disappointing, the Newcastle crowd's response, I'm afraid, to the Puerto Rican national anthem, which was observed with less than reverence.
Ladies and gentlemen in attendance, boxing fans joining us across the UK on Sky Sports, and sports fans joining us around the world, we welcome you to the Newcastle Arena here in beautiful Newcastle, England, as it is time for the main event of the evening. And it's all brought to you by Frank Warren's Sports Network and Don King Productions, as sponsored by MBC and Adidas. This bout coming your way is sanctioned by the World Boxing Organization. President Francisco Valcarce, supervisor at ringside John Montano, along with the British Boxing Board of Control, the stewards in charge, Nipper Reed and Bob Ray. Position at ringside, Dr. Alan Trotter, timekeeper at the bell, Albert Kelleher, judges at ringside, scoring this bout, Rafael Lopez, Victor Salomon, and Giuseppe Tondaro. And introducing to you our referee in charge, working in this, his 40th world title bout, introducing Raul Caiz. All right, fans, here we go with the main evening. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, it's showtime! With the WBO Featherweight Championship of the World scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Introducing to you first the challenger on my left, fighting out of the red corner, entering the ring wearing red, white, and blue trunks, fighting out of and representing Santurce, Puerto Rico. He weighed in at 8 stone, 11 and 3 quarter pounds, or 125 and 3 quarter U.S. pounds. Here is the former amateur champion who is undefeated in his campaign in the ring with 15 wins, no losses, 13 big wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, he is making his first attempt at a world title. Please welcome the undefeated WBO number one featherweight contender, introducing Daniel Pepino Alicea. And his opponent across the ring on my right is the colorful defending world champion fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring wearing gold trunks with black trim. He is hailing from his hometown of Sheffield, England, and proudly representing his heritage of Yemen. His weight the same as his opponent, 8 stone, 13 and 3 quarter pounds, or 125 and 3 quarter U.S. pounds. His outstanding unbeaten record includes 21 wins, no losses, with 19 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, he is making his second defense of his title. Please welcome one of boxing's young sensations. Here is the one and only and one of a kind, undefeated WBO featherweight champion of the world, introducing a prince, Once again, our referee in charge of this bout now to give instructions, Raul Pais.
Well, while that was going on, Prince Naseem Hamed was trying to taunt Alicea about what he was about to do to him. Remember this fight, for the first time ever, Prince Naseem Hamed being shown live in the United States. The boxing fraternity there have heard all about him, but your average sports fan certainly hasn't. This is his chance to impress them and maybe get all the talk going about a big fight with the likes of a Barrera
or
a Zuma Nelson. But remember, last time out, he went in 35 seconds, Prince Naseem, the fourth fastest win in world title history against Saeed Lawal. What has Alicea got to offer? Good enough to be a world champion, junior champion as an amateur. Naseem is always looking to throw punches from unusual angles. There's been talk in the build-up to this of him throwing a secret punch that he's been working on. Two very good left hands from him there. Big factor in the fight is whether Alicea can take a shot. Anyone who fights Prince Naseem will need that quality if they're to beat him. Durability and resilience, because he does hit by all accounts like a middleweight, even though he's a featherweight.
Alicea also needs to be able to react very quickly, because the punches from Hamed come from all sorts of angles very quickly. So Alicea has to be able to react. He has to read what Hamed is going to do.
Remember, even a battle-hardened fighter like Steve Robinson, who had a several world title fights, could barely lay a glove on Prince Naseem. Alicea covering up very well, getting his arms up well to try and block those punches from whatever angle. A right hand gets through from Alicea. He did catch Naseem with one there. Good right over the top though from Naseem.
Well, Alicea keeping his hands up quite well. That's very important, the defense. Just as Naseem went to throw his left, he got caught off Alicea's right.
Good fast right hand from Naseem. Alicea has taken the punch as well so far. Naseem is talking to him as usual. He's had some criticism from some sections of the media for trying to humiliate opponents in the past. Thin line between psychological warfare and tastelessness, of course. But Alicea looks full of ambition here and belief.
Yes, and certainly he's not psyched out in any way. Good right hand again.
Oh, he's got him down. Naseem is put down by a right hand. It was only a flash knockdown, but he'll have to take a mandatory 8 count.
down for the first time in his career. What about this in the first round? He wasn't so elusive there. Waving Alicea in.
Well, this is the questions we want asked. What is Hamed like when he's getting hit? And he went down. So this is a very different fight now. We know that Alicea can get to him.
Well, Alicea might have heard about the reputation, but he's taking no notice of it. What about that? Alicea puts Naseem Hamed down for the first time in his career. Flash knockdown, really. But how much has that dented Hamed's confidence? We thought this might be a tricky fight for him, and it shapes that way.
And a good punch there, good long right hand. You see the hands are right down, catches it again, long spearing right hand to the chin. And again, just as he was getting away from that one didn't seem to have the full power in it, but look at that one did. He took that one quite well, Hamed, but there was more to come. That one just pushed him over. There you see it, wonderful punch. You see where the hands were there. Alicea nice and tight with his defense and good reactions.
Alicea, who says he's looked at a lot of videos of Naseem Hamed, he spotted weaknesses and he says tonight he will expose them. Has he already started to do that? Second round. Well, this is the most interesting Prince Naseem Hamed fight, well, I'd say ever already, and we've only had a round of it. Round two, Alicea in the stripes.
And this is where you wonder what's happening in Hamed, in his mind. Is this confidence starting to go? Can he keep the confidence up?
Alicea's rangy long arms, and again, Naseem is getting caught more tonight than I think I've seen him caught in probably 10 fights. Got through with a right hand, but Alicea is showing good resilience so far. Every time Naseem lands, he just takes the punch. He looks a real hard nut, doesn't he?
He really does. He looks stronger. But Hamed come back well there with a couple of nice loose punches that really seem to land heavily on Alicea.
The Prince is used to seeing fighters fall apart when he lands with his heavy artillery. But Alicea, so far anyway, hasn't done this. And what's making this fascinating is that Prince Naseem Hamed is being asked questions that we haven't seen before. He's caught by a right uppercut. And that almost limbo dancer style defense of his is being put to the test.
But often the head movement like that, it's very difficult to get out of the way of all of the punches. He's got to try and get his hands off Hamed here.
Just switching orthodox for a moment there, Hamed.
Good solid right hand there.
Oh, left hook, and down goes Alicea. There's the answer. And he's in a bad way on very unsteady legs. It was a left hook that did it in the second round. And Prince Naseem reasserts himself.
It looked a very heavy right hand, then that little short left hook. He went down heavily there. Bad moment for Alicea.
Can his head clear? Can he get through this? This is a vital last 45 seconds. Another right hand. Has his legs splayed in the corner. Needs to get the gloves up. The final bell for this round cannot come soon enough for Alicea, who lands a very good left hook of his own. Under half a minute left in this round. Naseem looking to build on that breakthrough. Knocked down in both rounds so far.
Heavy
right
punches.
And a left. And I don't think he'll get up from that. It's called off. The fight is over. The fight is over. There'll be no count. He's won it in round two. The ninth time he's won in round two. And that was Hamed's answer to suffering the first knockdown of his career. The finish really was chilling and frightening. And Alicea is still down. And Prince Naseem Hamed retains his WBO featherweight championship against a young fighter who arrived with a lot of belief, who put him on the floor. But Hamed, give him credit, there was the answer.
That's right, Alicea asked Hamed them questions, the ones we've all wanted to know. Hamed answered them fantastically.
very good power punching, found the angles, and really went down very heavily. Really does carry some power in his fists.
Alicea managed to land more punches on Hamed, certainly than Steve Robinson did on the whole of the eight rounds those two fought. It was only two rounds, but what an interesting two rounds they were.
They certainly were. Alicea really came out to have a fight, wasn't overawed, took the fight to Hamed, hurt Hamed, put him over, and it looked as if Hamed may have a lot more in this fight than he was going to bargain for. But Hamed answered the questions fantastically. He came back, beautiful punches and very heavy hands.
This is how it finished. It was a two-punch combination.
Look, he just gets the rhythm in the shots. The left, the right comes up, and then the following left. All the momentum in this punch, a nice rhythm. Also, Alicea caught him there, but he still had enough to land that left hook. And look how heavily he goes down. They were hard, hard punches.
He's now floored 20 of the 22 opponents he's fought, Prince Naseem Hamed. He scored 38 knockdowns already in his career. Only two men have gone the distance with him. But what do we read by the fact that he was put on the floor? Well, you know, people like even Ali was put on the floor, wasn't he, by Henry Cooper and Sonny Banks early on. Nothing wrong with that, as long as you get up and win.
Certainly not with the style that Hamed has, when his hands are very low. He relies on reactions. And you know, he got caught some decent punches, he went down, but he got straight back up and he was okay. And then to come back and knock his opponent out in that fashion, obviously, you know, it tells a great deal. And there was questions to be answered, he answered them so well there.
He said he'd win in round three, he did it in round two, but it was not the usual formality for him. There were bad moments in that fight, and be interesting to hear what he says about all of that, the knockdown.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 2 minutes 46 seconds of round number 2. Our referee in charge, Raul Cais, stops the contest. He's the winner by way of technical knockout, still undefeated, and still the WBO featherweight champion of the world, Prince Naseem Hamed.
Newcastle fans enjoyed that. Hamed fights do tend to be short, but they are on the spectacular side. There'll be talk now, more talk, about a match with Marco Antonio Barrera, the brilliant Mexican. I must say I'd steer pretty clear of him. Not necessarily because Hamed would lose the fight, but it is extremely dangerous, of course, for anybody who fights him. And what about Hamed against the veteran Azuma Nelson, who's recently defended his super featherweight title?
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, great fights and prospect, but you gotta put him in with anybody.
Colin McMillan, the British featherweight champion, would certainly be among those towards the front of the queue. He's here tonight working for radio and will be pushing his case. But Hamed has successfully defended the WBO featherweight championship he won from Steve Robinson for a second time.
And I'm sure the American audiences are going to be very impressed with that.
We'll try to get some American reaction for you before we go off the air tonight as to what they might have made of that. Our colleagues from Showtime, the big cable network in the United States, showing this fight. They're the people who show Mike Tyson over in the States. Wasn't in the script for Hamed to go down, that's for certain. But he got up, and how he produced the finish. In just a moment or two, we'll get his version of events when he speaks to Gary Norman. No signs either of the problems with the right hand that he suffered earlier on. Here he is with Gary.
Naz, strong, two rounds.
Naz, let me tell you, awesome power. You stopped a very dangerous opponent there, and you answered a few questions as well.
To tell you the truth, I felt so good in there, but when he hit me with a good shot, I didn't even see the shot. But to tell you the truth, I got back up, know where my feet were, and when I plant my punches, see, I'm just too strong. When they connected and I put my preciseness together, my accuracy, it connected beautifully. And I hit him, I told you, when I hit him, they're going down from Allah. They're getting knocked out from Allah.
Many people have said they wanted to get you hit on the chin. What did it feel like when you went down for
it
the first
good.
Time?
It was beautiful. It was good. It was nice to taste, a nice, good shot by a good, very, very good fighter, undefeated. But as you see, my heart and my power and Allah behind me, I got up, I planted my punches, planted my feet. Allahu Akbar, I just hit him so hard. He weren't getting up from that last shot, you saw it yourself.
When you need you just pull one of those sucker punches out and it just stops them dead in their tracks.
Just stops them in the tracks, as you say. I hit him so hard, especially the second time. I put my punches together and I just, boom, there you go.
Now, Showtime, we're here. That's going to go coast to coast in America. Yeah. It was very important for you to look good.
To tell you the truth, I didn't think I looked as good as I could have looked. The finishing knockdowns and everything like that was beautiful. I knocked him and I hit him with some very, very good shots. But I could have boxed better than that. I could have not got hit at all, and I normally never get hit. But what the hell? I got hit with a good shot. My heart's with me. Allah's with me. I got up. I planted my feet. I hit him so hard. That's why I'm never, ever going to get beat, Gary. I'm never going to get beat. Full stop. I refuse to lose. Allah will never make me lose. I will never lose. Full stop.
What would you like to do now?
Pardon?
What would you like to do now, fight-wise? What's next?
I want to fight any of them. I want to go to the States. I want to fight in England. I want to box the best fighters in the world. I'm the best fighter in the world. I'm going to knock Barrera out. I'll knock all of them out. Azuma Nelson. They know the punching power. After seeing that fight, they know. I got hit, got up, took him out. I predicted the second round, the third at first, and then I changed my mind to the second round, and I gave him a good beating.
You're right, I heard you in the dressing room, you changed from 3-2. Frank Warren, that went to America. Is there a possibility who could fight in America next?
There's a strong possibility, but we've got to talk over the weekend, and I'll be talking to the Showtime people and to Don King, and we'll decide what we're going to do. But, you know, you just see the best fighter, I think, honestly, that we've produced. He proved, if he's hurt, he's an even more dangerous fighter. He got caught with a good shot, went down, got up, heart of a lion, and knocked the guy out. Absolutely poleaxed him.
I ain't losing that belt.
In many ways, it's good to see them get
Everybody
tested like that.
Everybody wanted to see it happen. Well, you've seen it happen, and you've seen him get up. He thought he's in there with a good fighter, a very good fighter, big heart, in the lion's den. And the kid took the fight to Alicea and four marks in.
There ain't nobody
who can take that power. There ain't nobody around, I promise you.
There's a rumour that he could fight on the Tyson undercard. I mean, you know, two rounds. He's still ready to go. When could we see him go across the water to the States? 6 weeks, 8 weeks?
I don't know. It's something we're talking about. We'll let you know next week.
All right, we'll watch this space with interest. Last
Gary,
word with you.
You see this belt here, I ain't losing, so I ain't going to lose this belt. You see this nice belt? I'm never, ever going to lose. Blatantly, I ain't losing nothing.
What you need is a few more. They'll come. Thanks, lads.
So Hamid achieves his regular ambition, which is to make the interview last slightly longer than the fight, but he had to extend the interview just a little bit to get to that goal this time round. It was pretty dramatic while it lasted, wasn't it? Thoughts of Jim Watt and Barry McGuigan when we come back, and we'll see the heavyweight prospect, the best heavyweight of the moment in Britain, certainly Scott Welch, in action live in Newcastle when we come back. Britain's triple heavyweight title holder Scott Welch in action here in the Newcastle Arena in just a couple of minutes' time. In racking up 21 professional wins out of 21, Prince Naseem Hamed had left one very important question unanswered until tonight. Barry McGuigan and Jim Watt with me to witness what, again, the professional opinion had waited for, Barry, the moment when Hamed was down.
Yeah, well, we wanted to know, and the question mark always remained over whether or not he could digest a decent punch. Alicea, as we said earlier, is only a young professional, he's only had 15 professional fights, but he certainly has a great deal of quality about him. And he came out there purposeful in the first round, and he showed that he can hit, and he showed that he can hit with power, and he showed that Hamed is vulnerable. And what's his first right hand was... the first right hand was absolutely brilliant. Snapped his head round. That's the first one. The second one, he stepped right in and he hit Hamid. Now, Hamid's feet are right in the position to stop himself from going down, but he switched his lights off there. He hit him really hard. And again, we see it from a different angle. But this one here snapped his head round, shook his senses, and this next right hand, bang.
Jim, how did you see it?
Yeah, well, first of all, we have to say Hamed beat a good little fighter tonight. Obviously not experienced, as Barry was saying, but a good little fighter. He did everything right. He did everything you would tell an opponent to do against Hamed. Get your feet close before you throw punches. Keep your chin down, your hands up when you're not throwing punches. and really won the first round. They scored a knockdown in the process, but in the second round, Hamed steps up a gear and just leaves them completely behind.
Absolutely.
Certainly a special talent. I mean, that was a good little fighter Hamed beat tonight. You have to give him credit for that.
Let's see Barry how he demolished the challenge in the second round.
The second round, the legs started going at that stage. He hit him with a right hand round the side. What makes Hamed so dangerous, he punches from the most unusual angles you could possibly imagine. Look at the legs going. He's already delivered that punch in the blink of an eye, and he stands right in your face. He shows you his chin, he shows you he's there, and we have seen in this fight tonight that he is vulnerable because he stands up close, but he's able to deliver that sort of power, and he's got such, he propels himself into these punches, winds all his weight in behind it, and lands with tremendous power, and that really was the beginning of the end. He never really got over
it. So, for you, even though he's unorthodox, he's still technically perfect in the way he punches.
Oh, he punches with incredible power. There's nothing technically perfect about him. That's what makes him so brilliant. He's unusual. He punches from different angles, but he's got the sort of power. Look at the guy's eyes there. He was out of it. And he's got the sort of concussive punching power to knock you out with one shot, and from any angle.
Jim, he's building up a career record as a very, very, very destructive puncher, isn't he? At world level.
I think what the Americans will see is that it wasn't probably his best performance to be shown there live across America. I think he could have looked a lot better. He took more punches in that first round than he's taken in half of his career. He made a lot of mistakes. He looked a little bit disjointed and ragged at times. But really, what I'll go home remembering is a tremendous power. And we have to give Alicea some credit. The first knockdown punch would have finished a lot of people. But Alicea got up from that. His legs had gone, but he did everything right again, on the defensive, just got his head clear, then come back at Hamed again. And Hamed switched the power back on, and again, one punch finished the job.
Are you more convinced by Hamed having seen that tonight?
Well, I've been convinced. Until Hamed fights a superstar, someone like Azuma Nelson, who we know won't stand for the messing about. That little fellow coped with the messing about well, but he'd never seen anything like it before. Azuma Nelson has seen everything. If Hamed can produce the goods against someone like Azuma Nelson, then he's as good as he says he is.
Barry?
I think that his performance tonight was remarkable. What he done in the first round, he made mistakes. He came out in the second round, fought the same way, with a little bit more caution and a little bit more speed. And there's no doubt about it, he needs someone like Nelson to bring the best out of him. And if he performs that way, I don't see many guys out there, including Nelson, being able to beat him. It's a fantastic performance, remarkable.
How will it go down in America?
I think that will be a tremendous promotion for Hamed. Tremendous promotion for him. I mean, they know about him over the boxing fraternity. Now the public at large know about him, and he can be a big star over there, no doubt about it.
It would be obviously more difficult, Jim, if he is asked to come and perform in the United States, away from home, etc.
Yes, the States is a tremendously big place. I think his power will certainly have impressed a lot of people. But he's the type of fellow, you see the temperament that Naz has. I've never seen a temperament like that. He should be nervous in the dressing room. It offends me, the fact that he sits so relaxed.
Sure.
I was never like that in my life. I mean, I had a fairly good temperament.
This is different from when you were a professional boxer,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, it's a little bit different.
The game's moved on a bit, really.
Well, I never thought we'd see Naz carried out after the fight, but in this manner we can put up with that, I suppose.
Yes, indeed. What he does have as well, looking around the crowd here at the Newcastle Arena, Barry, young people come to watch this man who may not naturally be boxing supporters.
There's no doubt about it. This guy transcends the sport. People who know nothing about boxing know about Naseem Hamed. The kids watch him. They're interested, and they all want to dance to his music. The crowd were dancing to the music on the way out there. It's part of the show now. That's it. I mean, the old timers don't necessarily agree with it, but it's part of the show, and it's a great thing. It's great for boxing. The fact is, more people who aren't necessarily boxing fans are watching the sport as a result of Naz, and that can only be good.